Hi folks, this be David Kwan here. It's been a while since I did this. This is actually like my first time, I think, using the YouTube website capture from webcam feature that I'm doing this. But it's me usual, you know, being in front of being using my MacBook camera to just do a blog or whatever. Today is pretty exciting. The exciting news today that I found out, you know, I'm coming home from work. And I look at my Twitter feed, and oh my goodness, you know, this is something that a lot of gay rights activists and kind of people have been really, really, really pushing for all this time. And gay marriage is now legal across all 50 states, thanks to the Supreme Court decision that just happened. It's a pretty momentous victory, and I'm definitely excited. But at the same time, I kind of think back, and I want to make a good reminder to myself and to those of you watching, you know, that this is just kind of one little tiny thing in the movement towards, you know, lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, and allies, and plus all those kind of things, equality for LGBTQ plus. This is just one and tiny aspects of that movement, I think, and it's a big win. But it's also, compared to the objectives of the entire movement, it's also a very small win in some sense. I think I hearken back to when I was an undergrad, and one of the classes I took was in the American Studies department. My major is social work, not American Studies, but we were required to take classes that were outside of the social work school. And so one of the classes I took was called something like intersections of race, sexuality, gender, and kind of other identity issues. And the professor that kind of taught this course was really kind of honing in on the point about the movement to have beyond marriage. Marriage is something that's really important in some sense, but what's also at stake are the rights that are attached to marriage for a lot of people. I'm not saying that every, you know, person views marriage in that way, but also leaves out a lot of the other struggles and discriminations and everyday challenges that the LGBTQ plus people face in America. And that has a lot, I mean, there's still so many things that this movement still needs to continue to fight for and to consider, that the society gives benefits and recognition to a married couple. It's just one tiny aspect of what the movement needs to consider, I think. I'm going to link in the video description and the full statement by beyondmarriage.com, I think, or .org, I forget which, but I'll link it in the video description. And that's kind of talking more about the recognition of all kinds of family structures, all kinds of intimacy, and also the what I would also want to add is the plight of or the challenges that LGBTQ individuals and families and friendships and kind of partnerships they face every day. And that's kind of employment challenges. They have no employment protections across so many states, about 29 states, I think, or 34 states, including transgender, in which somebody could be fired, not hired, not promoted, simply because of their sexual orientation or gender identity, which is quite alarming. There's still a lot of bullying that happens because in schools, in colleges, in workplaces, and things of that nature because of someone's identity. One of the biggest reasons of youth homelessness is because of LGBTQ identity and such. There's still so much to kind of work towards in this movement, and what I fear is that because of this marriage equality victory, that a lot of the allies start thinking, oh my gosh, the battle is won, you know, gay rights is kind of it's a done deal, we're in a post-gay equality society. That's kind of what I worry about, kind of like how after President Barack Obama was elected president, it's like, oh my gosh, we now have a black president, racism doesn't exist anymore, kind of thing, is what I worry about. You know, I think the movement, still, there's still so much work left to be done in this movement, and that's kind of what I want to hone in on, that We still need to. We've always had to look just beyond the marriage fight. There are still socioeconomic, political factors that make life especially more difficult and challenging and stigmatizing for those who identify either in a closeted manner or out and about as gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, queer, or otherwise not heterosexual gender identity. So that's kind of my two cents in doing a blog in a long time. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed, cheers.